Hello YouTube, this is Almighty Smetjen. Today's movie is about Final Fantasy X and how you get all the Ultima or Celestial weapons. So here we go. Once you have the airship, you can start collecting the Ultima weapons. But before we do that, it is best to get a weapon with the No Encounters ability, so you can explore Spira without battles. The monster at Bash Temple in the water can drop this weapon. In this location you can also recruit Enema if you have found all the 6 destruction spheres in the temples. For the destruction sphere in Zenerkent, go back once you have the airship and find the 7 white squares and the destruction sphere will show up. Now, the location of Bash Temple is X14 and Y60. Now we go to Bash Temple. The monster can use Stone Punch, so if you have any equipment that protects against stone, equip this for Tidus, Waka and Riku.
The final showdown. Yeah, here we go.
Now simply use your overdrives. For Waka you have to have the attack reels overdrive. You can get this at the first tournament prize at the Blitzball game. If the monster doesn't drop a weapon with no encounters, just retry until it drops it. Before you can open the chest with the ultimate weapons, you need the Celestial Mirror. First, go to Rhenium Temple and win the Chocobo Race to obtain the Cloudy Mirror. And now go to Makalania Woods. Now at Makalania Woods you have to do a little side quest. First you will need to find the husband of the woman at the entrance. Now go back to the woman and now you have to find the child. Mm-hmm. take the hidden road. And upgrade your cloudy mirror into the celestial mirror. At this location, you can also upgrade your Ultima weapons. To fully upgrade your weapons, you will need for each weapon a sigil and a crest. Yuna's Ultima weapon is the Nirvana. To obtain the Nirvana, catch one of all the beasts at the Calmlands. For the Moon Sigil, we have to defeat all Belgemina's Aeons at Rhenium Temple, including Yojimbo, Anima and the Magus Sisters.
If you... Very well. Now, are you ready? Yes. It is in your hands. Destroy Sin and save Spira.
Now, if you want to recruit Anima, just go inside the temple if you found all the six destruction spheres in the temples.
Come, Summoner. I will bestow you with my power. The Dark Aeon, Anima. Destroy Sin, and my son's obsession with it. Though it is small recompense for what I did to him.
If you want the hidden Aeon, the Magus Sisters, you need two things, the Blossom Crown and the Flower Scepter. The Blossom Crown you can get by catching one of all the bees at Mount Kegazet. The second thing you need is the Flower Scepter. You can get it by defeating Belgema Aeons at Rhenium Temple until Bahamut. Now, once you have the Blossom Crown and the Flower Scepter, go inside Rhenium Temple and go recruit the Magus Sisters. The moon crest can be found at Besaid Beach. Now go back to Makalania Woods and upgrade Yuna's Ultima weapon. You have to do this for every weapon. That's it for the Nirvana. Auron's ultimate weapon can be found at the Mushroom Rock. But first you need to collect the Rusty Sword. You can find this nearby the entrance of the sunken cave with Shojimbo. Auron's crest can be found at the Meehan High Road at the end of the Old Road. Now for Kimari Spirit Lance, pray at 3 cactuar stones when they are lit up with the square button and then go to the broken tower and pray. For Kimari's crest, it can be found at Mount Gagazet between two pillars. It's the place after you beat Seema. For Kimari's sigil, you need to complete the 2 butterfly challenges at Makalania Woods. You can do this after you have the airship. At the end, don't leave the screen, otherwise you need to restart the challenge. Lulu's Onion Knight can be found at Barsh Temple. Now, for Lulu's Seagull, you have to dodge 200 lightning balls at the Thunder Plains. It can be done easily, because there is a place where you can trigger automatically a lightning bolt. It's in this crater. Just run into the crater and tap the X button. Turn around and go back. You can do this in 15 minutes. Have a weapon with the no encounters ability. For Lulu's Crest, once you have the airship, go back to the far plane and there will be a chest with the Venus Crest. For Riku's ultimate weapon, the God Hand, input the password God Hand at the airship. Now go to Mushroom Rock.
Yeah, here we go.
And you will find a chest with Riku's ultimate weapon, the God Hand. Riku's Crest can be found at the Sanobio Desert west, in a pit. For Riku's sigil, you have to complete the Cactuar quest at Sanubia Desert. You must find the 10 gatekeepers and put their spheres into this Cactuar stone. I will show you quickly all the locations of the missing gatekeepers. The first gatekeeper can be found at the oasis. The second one is in Desert East. The third one is found in Desert West, at this sign. The fourth and the fifth gatekeeper can be found at Desert Central. Go west at the Seisphere. The sixth one can be found at Desert East at the Seisphere. The seventh gatekeeper can be found at Desert Central in a chest in the southwest corner. The eighth one is at Desert West in one of the two pits. If he isn't there, leave the screen and come back until he shows up. Now for the ninth one, go to the oasis and see him take the Seisphere to the airship. And now go to the deck of the airship and he will be there. After you put the 9 Cactuar spheres into the Cactuar stone, the last gatekeeper will show up behind you. Now for Tidus' ultimate weapon, it's located north at the Calmlands. You must go down this cliff, but a man will block your way. Now just beat the Chocobo trainer at the Catcher Chocobo race. See that you don't leave the Calmlands and come back here, and the man don't block your way anymore. For Tidus Suncrest, once you have the airship and have beaten Unalaska, go back to Xenarkand Doom and you will find a chest with the Suncrest. Now, for Taiya's Sun Seagull, your time must be 0 or beneath 0 seconds at the catcher chocobo race. This can be a little tricky. For Waka's world champion, win 5 blitzball games and go to Luca's Cafe. Waka's crest can be found in the locker room of the besieged Aurochs in Luca. For Waka's Jupiter Seagull, you have to play Blitzball. The fastest way you can get this seagull is by winning 26 Blitzball games in total, 2 tournaments and 2 leagues. But before the seagull will show up in a league prize, you must have all Waka's overdrives. The attack reels you can get very soon in the game after you leave Luca, because then Blitzball becomes available. In Luca, go recruit Wedge, Shu, Zalitz, Zef Ronso and Jumal. And normally you will win the first tournament easily and get the attack reels. Then wait until you have the airship and have beaten Unalaska, and on your way to Zanarkand, recruit Brother, he is on the airship, and Rob, he is in the Meehan High Road Agency. The status reels is a league prize, and it will show up when you have fought 250 battles with Waka. The Aurochs reels is a tournament prize, and it will show up when you have fought 450 battles with Waka. And then the Jupiter seal is a league prize. Now I'm gonna show you how you can change the prizes at the leagues and the tournaments. The Aurochs reels is a tournament prize. Normally when you have fought 450 battles, it will show up automatically. If it doesn't show up, just go out the Blitzball screen and re-enter until the prize shows up. Now, for the status reels and the Jupiter Seagull, it's a league prize, and you can change the prize by resetting the data. At this point of the game, I have already have all Waka's overdrives. So the Jupiter Seagull must show up in a league prize. So it's very easy. Attack reels, first tournament prize, then status reels, a league prize, then Auroch reels, a tournament prize, and then the Jupiter seal, a league prize, in that order. But remember, after you reset the data, you must recruit again your Blitzball players. I'm gonna show you quickly where they are. Brother is on the airship. Rob, Meehan High Road Agency. Wedge, Lucas Stadium, Main Gate. Jamal, Lucas Square. Zalitz, Lucas Theater. Now for your team, Tidus and Wedge attackers. See that you have learned the jackshot for Tidus. You can learn this very early in the game, when you take the boat from Kileka to Luka. Brother, he has high speed. Once you have the ball, give him a pass and take your opponents with him. And then give a pass to Tidus and Wedge and try to score a goal. Rob and Zalitz are one of the best defenders at the beginning of the game. And Jamal is a good keeper because he already knows the super goalie technique. Now the first games are a little bit difficult. Now we're gonna show you how to easily score a goal. Once you have the ball, give a pass to Brother. And take all your opponents with you. Brother is very fast. Now give a pass to Tidus or Wedge and go to the goal and score. That's it for the Ultimate Weapons. This was Almighty Smetje. If you have any questions, please ask me on my channel.